Yeah, thank you very much for the kind introduction, lieber Herr Corwitz. Although you have already taken half of my presentation, I would like to discuss later with you. But okay, we shall see. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the session of this afternoon, and addressed to my old and long-standing friend Arno. I have to say it has always been my preferred time slot to talk, to have an afternoon talk right after lunch, especially when it is on such an exciting topic as a German national politics initiative. But I do hope I can prevent you from falling into the lunch coma. Seriously, I'm happy to talk a little bit about the status we have reached so far with the German Council for Scientific Information Infrastructures, abbreviated in RFII, Rat für Informationsinfrastrukturen. And, well, in a nutshell, it is a national advisory council jointly founded and funded, but jointly founded by the federal government, the so-called Bund, and the federal states, the so-called Länder. And as Mr. Corwitz has already mentioned, you have to understand it, especially those of you who are not so familiar with the German federal system, that we have a split in funding and in responsibilities in Germany concerning Bund and Länder. And for example, the Länder have the sovereignty over the universities, also the funding of the universities, and the Bund has the sovereignty over the non-university, universitarian institutes and societies, as of Max Planck Society or Helmholtz or also Leibniz. One need to understand that since this has been a joint decision of the Bund and the Länder, and it has been a joint decision of the so-called Joint Science Conference. And the Joint Science Conference jointly decides about overall funding and processes and structures in the German science system. And it is an important task of hers to sustain the quality, the excellence, and the international competitiveness of science and research. And so it was the council is a national advisory council, and its mission is to align the digital transformation in science with future-proof information infrastructures on a national level. And so you can see, we have already heard this in the morning, that information infrastructure has been finally recognized or even acknowledged by the politicians as an, due to the digital shift, increasingly important element of the country's research infrastructure. That's not self-understanding. And so the council shall monitor developments across disciplines and institutions, both at the national and also at the international level, and such as the European Science Cloud, the Research Data Alliance, the open science community movement, and shifts in the commercializing domain. And its mandate is to compile recommendations related, as I said, to structures, processes, and hopefully solutions on the system level. And these recommendations will be directed to the Bund and the Länder, as well as to science. And that sounds easy, but as Mr. Corwitz has already mentioned it, it's not that easy compared with the reality of the federal system we have here in Germany. It was constituted, the Council, in November 2014, and for an initial pilot phase of 4 years, and we have 24 experts, members, I will come back to that later, representing key stakeholder groups. And so the Council's first real working meeting took place in January 2015, here in Berlin, by the way, in the Ministry for Science and Research. And so today I can present some outcomes after its first anniversary. Maybe a little bit it would be interesting to look at the political background. And to pigeonhole the Council in its context. And here's a quote from the coalition agreement of the current German federal government. We will develop a strategy for the digital transformation in science for enhanced accessibility of research data. So in the coalition agreement, we have already the term research data, which is quite sensational. Together with the German Länder, we will fund a Council for Scientific Information Infrastructure, which coordinates stakeholders in the national science system and drives the development of strategies and standards across disciplines and institutions. And you can imagine the effort it had taken behind the scenes to get this put in the coalition agreement. And I think it exemplifies very clearly the growing awareness at the top political level for the significance of information infrastructures as part of the German science system. It was a long way to get to that, and precisely it was about 10 years, very roughly. Here only a very, very few examples of reports and recommendations above the time scale initiated by the joint science conference, Bund and Länder, and a lot more initiatives, for example, from the German Research Foundation, from the Alliance Ralf Schimmer mentioned, had been initiated and had significant impact. But in 2011, we had the so-called Commission for the Future of Information Infrastructures with the outcome of a very large report and recommendations. Then these recommendations were more or less confirmed 1 year later by the so-called Wissenschaftsrat, the German Council of Science and Humanities. And finally, in 2014, we had the constitution of the Council for Information Infrastructures. And below the timescale, I decided to start it with 2003 with the Berlin Declaration. I think that was one of the initial international initiatives pushing things forward outside of the political debate at that time. And then we had the OECD principles and guidelines, and you can see lots of things did happen at the EU level. And I mentioned only the report Riding the Wave in 2010, which had a lot of impact on the discussions also here. And we had in 2013 the launch of the Research Data Alliance, and then the launch of the current program Horizon 2020, where research infrastructures, including e-infrastructures, play an important role in the entire system of the program. So just a little glance at the history. And the topics, actually, they are evergreens. They have not changed since more or less 10 years. It's all about hosting and long-term preservation, retro digitization and cultural heritage, research data production, research data management, open access, of course, virtual research environments and licensing strategies. But these topics are evergreens. Yesterday, today, who knows what will be tomorrow, but they are still very, very current, and in important details, they are still unresolved. And that's the reason we also have the Council now. And we do have, the message is, we do have the need to reshaping the landscape, the split landscape concerning responsibilities on the one hand and also leadership on these topics. And up to now, and that's already an achievement, all stakeholders involved are at least or have at least agreed upon the challenges deriving or derived from the digital transformation and the challenges and needs agreed upon. And that is that excellent science requires high performance, reliable information infrastructure in order to ensure the sustainable, that's a very important term, provision of information and knowledge and to enable innovation. And I think here is some interface with the non-university institutes or communities, the universities, the publishing communities, and we all have to serve science, and I think we have to get closer also together to achieve this in order to advance science and research. And that is, for example, the development of new web-based forms of research and publishing. It is a promotion of open access to scientific knowledge. No doubt that will alter the balance between or within the publication system, and the management of an increasing quantity of research data from the perspective of sustainable use and long-term availability. Availability is quite unsolved yet. And another topic or challenge is the development of innovative services and tools. It has already been mentioned this morning. And last but not least, it's a qualification, it's new profiles of specialists and design of new skills and professions. Well, this is the council, how it looks like, and some of you may know this guy, Herrn Hauf, my colleague from Thieme Chemistry Publishers, and you see the publishing community and the publishing area and the commercial publishing sector has already or is already involved in the council. And well, everybody is still smiling, and the picture was taken at the in November 2014. I think I don't have to tell you who everyone, the name of everyone on this picture, but maybe it's worthwhile to look at the composition and how the council is constituted. And it was based on the consideration that designing the future access to scientific information is a joint venture of information providers, of users, scientific users, of funders and other national stakeholders as the commercial publishers. And so we have four blocks. You see them. We have 8 representatives of the information providers or of the information infrastructure. We have 8 representatives of the scientific users. Those members had to be nominated, and every major community or society in Germany was entitled to nominate their favorite member to the council. For example, Max Planck, the Rectors Conference, the Helmholtz Society, and many others in Germany, and to nominate them to the German Research Foundation. And the German Research Foundation formed or compiled a pre-final list of whom they thought would be an appropriate member representing a broad scope of disciplines to the science. And then we have equally 4 representatives from public life, for example, from the publishers industry and from the press. And we have 4 representatives of Bund und Länder. And by the way, this model, for your information, follows the model the members of the Wissenschaftsrat in Germany are nominated and how the Wissenschaftsrat constitutes itself, just to give you a quick impression. And important is that the scientific users cover a broad scope of disciplines from archaeology, human sciences and humanities, astronomy, engineering, geography, life sciences and sociology, and as well do the scientific information infrastructures. We have the scientific information centers, for example. We have also museums, we have archives, and we have the important significant libraries represented there. And last but not least, also important, the high performance computing. And I have already talked about society and public life and Bund and Länder. And also important is that this scope incorporates some perspectives concerning Europe and beyond, and the members of the Council are actively involved, for example, in the European Network on Archival Cooperation, in the European Social Survey, in Global Biodiversity, in the Research Data Alliance, also in the SDM community, and last but not least, at the EU level, concerning the big program Horizon 2020, and there are two high-level advisory groups, one on research infrastructures, and one, as Baron Mons this morning was representing as the chair, the new formerly group on the Open Science Cloud. So that is, in brief, the perspectives and the experience and expertise the Council is representing. What are the expectations brought to the Council? The Council shall increase the level of transparency. I think that's very important. The level of transparency of developments, processes, and actions. A lot of things are going on at very different levels, at very in very different communities, at the EU level, at the national level, but also very many initiatives and very discipline-oriented and also cross-disciplinary oriented initiatives. And so it's not very easy, but the Council is assigned to increase that level of transparency. And it also shall leverage synergies, quite important, between the multitude of stakeholders. It shall facilitate and enhance collaboration, and it shall support and communicate German positions at the European and international level, which are not that much represented yet. It depends. And last but not least, it shall stress the increasing importance of information infrastructures in the scientific, but also in the cultural and in the economic context. And this means it's targeted also to drive innovation. Not enough. The Council shall further, and here it really becomes a tough challenge, compile substantial recommendations for the sustainable design of information infrastructures with respect to the international development. It shall foster the availability criteria as of long-term reliability, location, independent data and information, the legal aspects, the financial aspects, and the technical and the aspect of security. It's a big bunch, you know. Then it shall strengthen self-organizing processes within science and monitor the overall developments. And last but not least, it shall investigate requirements for supervision by science politics and science policy. And you see, the Council is under pressure to perform, and the time schedule defined by the Joint Science Conference is quite ambitious, and the Council, or we as the members, are expected to provide first recommendations already in summer this year and provide them to the Joint Science Conference in their fall meeting. Necessarily and consequently, we had to focus our work, and that's the outcome of the first year. The focus and the key commitment is to focus work and recommendations on the complex of, and maybe you will like to hear this, the complex of research data, sustainability, stable system, and internationalization. And why? And I think we have already heard about that. It is an important future for the potential for scientific advancement to exploit data and information from very different areas of public life and science. And at the same time, and here's why it comes to sustainability. At the same time, the infrastructures are needed to manage in a stable and robust way those data, and that requires newly shaped or performing structures and organizations. And last but not least, it has to be put in the international context. I think that's very clear. From an innovation policy and legal viewpoint, this area and this complex has great potential, for example, against the background of demands for the results of research to be available to third parties, for example, in a format where the data can be reused. So that was the background and why the Council has reached commitment to focus its work on that complex research data, sustainability, internationalization, and the first recommendations we are working on at the moment will refer to that complex only. One other outcome, the inaugural meeting, I have already said that, was held in November 2014. We had three plenary sessions since then, more than 30 presentations already, and meetings at the top political level in the Bund and in the ministries of the Länder, and the knowledge and the recognition of what's going on with information infrastructure and how significant they are. They are very different in the different political areas, and also it depends on the financial situations of the Länder, for example. In July 2014, some of you may have read it, the Council published its opening declaration and its work program, and we have set up four working groups in spring last year, and we have had in fall four internal reports only for internal purposes presented in fall 2015, but maybe some of it will be published. And those working groups are first sustainability, and the name in the boxes are referring to the chairs of those working groups. We have the working group on sustainability. The group will spotlight strategic, political, economic, and legal dimensions of a sustainable structure we have to achieve. Then we have a working group on international orientation, and this working group reviews international initiatives and compares national strategies, and it analyzes the international integration of information infrastructures as well as the chances and challenges that arise from it from German science, and it seeks to outline opportunities for German actors in both in the European and the global strategy development. Then we have a working group on terminology and definitions. And this working group aims to develop a helpful language on information infrastructures for a clear and intelligible stakeholder communication. And it is the task of this working group to examine existing terms. What means information infrastructure? To examine existing terms and to redefine them if necessary. And the activity is designed as a general basis for the Council work, and we may publish some of the definitions later for the entire community. And then we have a working group on plans or concepts analysis, and this group had to review and assess the papers and recommendations that have shaped the discourse since the beginning, and I think it was a very interesting work to do that, since that dates back to the 80s in the last century, we can say. And the working group's monitoring activity will allow the Council to track the effects of solutions and recommendations already given and already proposed over the time, and not to continue with old, maybe also failures. And this working group's activity is also designed as a general basis for the Council. And last but not least, lately we set up a panel for data protection And this will deal with issues of protection of personal data in research centered around new challenges for data protection posed by new methods of research, by reusing data, etc., etc. In the background or against the current political and legal regulations. First findings. Well, first findings, among those findings is that former plans and former concepts and papers and recommendations offer already clear analysis, cover the challenges, and have given proper recommendations. And many of those address or have addressed the need for action. Yet we have an implementation gap. And this implementation gap is due to barriers at different levels. We have already mentioned that. We have the German funding system split between Bund and Länder, having said that. And they are also institutional barriers. There are universities versus non-university research organization. We have the dominance so far of project-based funding in the infrastructure development. That means we don't have stable funding or finance after the project and after the project has ended. And that's a big challenge to find solutions for that. We have a lack of sustainable business models. And I think we also have maybe a lack of new business ideas. Baron Mons mentioned that earlier this morning, data stewardship, caring about that might be a new business model or a new business idea for the market, market-oriented infrastructure. Then we have a lack of incentives to deposit data for sharing or later reuse. These incentives for researchers and scientists, that has to be solved at a political but also at the publishing level. And we have a lack of sense still in some disciplines for the significance or for the importance of information infrastructures. And that depends on very much on the disciplines. And astronomy, for example, is far ahead. And the humanities are, I would not say behind, but it's a completely different way of research and methodological way to do research. And so it's not every scientist sees or recognizes the needs for using independent or sustainable information infrastructures. I'm very open. And last but not least, we have a lack of relevance and evaluation criteria for excellent information infrastructure. You know, we have this evaluation system in Germany, and there are some new criteria we are working on to bring it or to implement it in the system. Other findings are related to the challenges the Council has to cope with while compiling its recommendations, and that is some tension fields identified, and the Council has to address that some balance will be needed in terms of funding. So, of course, there need to be a balance between project-based versus institutional funding and financing. Another topic on funding is public or private, public-private partnerships. Then quite another aspect is coordination. Will it be better to do that top-down or to do it bottom-up or to have a mixture, and how can this look like? And another challenge is open data, open science, open everything versus control and ownership. I mentioned the data protection issue and the legal regulations we are still coping with. Things you are able to do at the technological side, you are not allowed to do on the legal side. And it's a big problem, and I think it will take some time to find appropriate solutions there. And another tangent field is on solutions and services. Will there be individual versus discipline specific versus generic solutions and services? There's also some balance needed. And then finance, investment. Finance are limited. We hear that every day from the political area and from our political leaders. And we have other problems, really very serious problems to solve, but we also need investments in infrastructure, but maybe also in human resources, in finding new professions, etc., in keeping brain here in Germany, and that's another tangent field. That's the findings so far. I'm allowed to talk. Many things are we are talking about behind the scenes. They are still private and confidential, and in 1 year we can report, we are certain to report some more precise and concrete things, but this is so far the outcomes the council has reached. And in 2016 and beyond, what is the council doing? Actually and currently, the council is working and compiling a so-called position paper for the Joint Science Conference. I have already mentioned it. This position paper relates to structures and processes related to the complex of research data and sustainability. And we expect a report of the data protection panel, of the council's data protection panel, and maybe some result can be a kind of data compass for regulations on a national level in compliance with the European level. And in general, the council wants to improve the links between science, politics, and economics, and also with the publishing area. And in doing so, it intends to reflect on possible measures required for the acceptance and feasibility of significant factors, including administrative, political, and financial aspects. And well, we are building on expertise of partners and of collaborateurs, as we say. And so we would like to foster collaboration at the national and international level. And this is not official yet, but the idea is maybe to hold a stakeholder conference in 2017. And maybe this conference, or maybe some of you, and maybe later on, and we can discuss a little bit more if there could be a connection. We don't know yet, but it is an idea, and just to get in closer contact, and since it's very clear that the council cannot solve all these problems and challenges on its own, and it's not entitled to do so, and so we need, and we would be happy to partner with experts at different levels as the publishing community is. And well, that's the current status and the perspective so far. This is a picture of the of the office. We have a very small office in Göttingen, and thank you very much for your attention.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yes, Mrs. Brunger-Weiland, this reminds me a little bit of the situation physicians are. The diagnosis is done and the evidence is there, but the therapy may be tricky. And so Arno, where's Arno? No? Well, this is the reason why we have to rejoin next year to hear what's happened here. Any questions from your side to Mrs. Brunger-Weiland? Yes, please, the microphone's there.
So maybe I have two questions. The first question, is there a country which is already, or a region, which is a benchmark for you on how to make such infrastructure? And maybe a small question after that, Could you say a little bit more about the internationalization of such infrastructure? I'd love to hear.
It was very much coined in this working group by the activities of the RDA, the research, this RDA movement, and there is a lot of attention on the UK. And since the structures are simpler in the UK, and the UK has reached a lot over the years, and one example is that there is a certain consultancy or a certain council directly reporting to the Prime Minister, which we are far away from that, but we are on the way. And so UK is very much on the focus, and also the USA. That's how far I know are the ideas at the moment.
So, any more? No? Well, thank you, Sabina.
Thank you.